Good day, viewers. Welcome to Cybertech-Arena. In this video, I'll walk you through how to use TailOS and Tor browser to browse the internet privately and securely. We'll also explore what the dark web really is and why you should be cautious. But before we proceed, this video is for educational purpose only, and I do not promote or encourage any illegal activity. This video will actually be in two parts. The first part is I'm going to show you how to use the Tor browser only plus your VPN to access the dark web, and this video is strictly for educational purpose, okay, and for enlightenment. So I will not be held liable for any misuse of this information. If you are a journalist or you are a cybersecurity professional or just a normal person who wants to browse securely online and also go to the dark web. So many people have their reason for trying to be anonymous, like free press and free speech and all that. So the first part, I will teach you how to access it with Tor browser and a VPN. Why the second part, I will teach you how to be anonymous and access the dark web through the TAZ OS, which is more secured way. All right, so don't miss any part of the video, because every second counts and there are vital information I dished out in this video. So to get Tor, you just go to torproject.org and you go to download browser. So it's going to, you choose the one you really want. I'm on Windows, so I'll just choose on Windows. I already had the file. So when you click it, it's going to download. So as you can see, it's downloading, but I'll cancel out from there because I already downloaded it. All right. So when the installation is done, it's just very simple. You just do next until it's done. So you turn on your VPN. This is it. You double click it. So that's after you've turned on your VPN. And so there are reasons why people want to stay anonymous. Most times journalists wants to stay anonymous for free press, and also for people like whistleblowers wants to stay anonymous. Then cybersecurity experts wants to stay anonymous when conducting their investigation, okay? So it's going to be a bit slow. You know, we're using the VPN also to make this. So here it is, it's open. So as you can see, the browser it uses is DuckDuckGo, which is another thing I'll say along the line in this video. All right, so this is Tor. This is Tor browser. So here, the security level, it's safest, meaning it's turned off for this thing. So let me click it so you see what I'm talking about. So here is standard. So when you just download yours might be in standard. You can turn it to the safest. It's going to, if you really want to stay anonymous, because that's the safest, going to cancel a lot of things like JavaScript and the rest of them. So another thing I want to let you know here is if you just want to explore the dark web as a journalist, cybersecurity professional, you can go ahead. Maybe you just want to breeze in there fast and do something. You can just use this. But if you want to be more anonymous and browse safely, because the dark web is not a place where you just go. People go there for various reasons. Like I said, this video is not for, this video is just for educational purpose, and nothing in this video should be used illegally. So this is the first step when you want to stay anonymous and also explore the dark web for research purpose. So the next method is through the TAZ OS. All right, then we'll talk about the dark web. All right, so to install TAZ OS, you need to go to TAZ.net. So you go to install this, then you don't need to choose anywhere, because the most secured way to install this is through the USB stick, because this is like it's an agnostic OS, meaning when you turn it off, it doesn't remember whatever you've done with it, and it's hardly traceable. Then secondly, your information is secure. Then thirdly, except you want to configure persistence. Persistence is like you want it to always remember and save your details and information, but that won't be in the context of this video. So you go to download TIS for USB stick. So it's going to show you this one, which is TIS, as of when I'm shooting this video, the latest one is TIS 6.16. Okay, so maybe in future it might be higher, but the process is the same, it remains the same. So you download it, you click on download. So it's going to start downloading. All right, it's going to start downloading the USB image. So I already had it downloaded because of time, so I just cut it off also. All right, so when you're done with this, when the TIS is done downloading, there's something you need again to install. This is rufus.ie, right? So /en/, so it's like English, because I'm doing this video in English, so I'll just give it subtitle to other languages. So when you're in this page, the Rufus page, you just you need the Rufus, so you just go to download. So when you're on this page, you choose, so the latest, I'll just choose the, depending on what you want, you can choose the standard version or the portable version. So I'll just use the portable version. You can download anyone, okay? So I'll just, anyone you choose, since it's on Windows and your OS, I'm on the 64-bit operating system. If you're on the 32-bit, you can choose this, all right? So we just choose the portable when you click it. So I also already downloaded this, so I'll cancel the download. So then when it's done downloading, you just install it by just clicking. This is it. I already did my installation. It's going to be an exe file, so you just click it, double click it. Yes, when it gives you any prompt, just click on yes to start it. So this is what it looks like. Then you need a USB stick of about minimum of 8 gigabytes. So this USB stick will be flashing the image you just downloaded into the USB stick. So I'll plug my USB stick just like you can see in the screen. So when you already downloaded Rufus and you open it, it's going to be like this. So TIS is going to detect Rufus is going to detect your USB stick automatically. Okay, so it's going to ask you to select the DIX image you want to flash it to. So it's going to be DIX or iOS image. So you're going to click on select. Then you go to your file where you downloaded the file, and you're going to choose it. So when you choose it, you just you can see when you choose it, you just go to start. But whatever you have in the USB stick, it's going to reformat it. So we just click on start. All right. It said warning, all data on USB device, TIS disk will be destroyed and all that. You said okay. So it's going to start deleting everything. Okay, when it's done deleting, it's going to write. Now it's writing it. So when it's 100, it's going to show you done. So I'll just fast forward the video so we get it fast. So it's done writing it. As you can see, it says ready. right? So we already flash the image into the USB stick. So now at this point, we just click on close. So what we're going to do now is we need to restart or reboot. At this point, what we're going to do is we need to restart or reboot our system. All right, for some computers, it's F12, and for some, it's F2, or whatever your own is. Some is F9, all right? So mine is F9. So I will restart it. But while you're restarting your system, make sure your USB stick where you flash the Tails OS is installed there. So I will restart mine now. So I'm using a HP laptop. So mine is F9. So I offed it and I will switch it on. So I'll continue to press F9. Press F9, yours might be F12, so mine is F9. So I'll get to this page where it's going to tell me notebook, hard drive, and so I'll choose, you must choose to book from the hard drive, all right? So I'll select that part, this one, which is the USB. So as you can see, it's booting into Tails. So we give it time to do it in. So as you can see, we're already booting into Tails, and when you get to this page, English or whatever, mine is English. You choose whatever works for you here. So I'll just go to Start Tails. So when you get to this page, you click on this part here, and here, as you can see, you can just connect to your Wi-Fi. All right. So I already connected mine. You go to here, application. So these are the things we have here. So if you join my YouTube membership subscription, I'll be teaching more on many things here, all right? But for now, we'll just focus on the Tor browser here. So we just open Tor connection. So when you get to this page, you connect automatically. You click, you select this one. So when you want to configure bridge, that's another topic for another day, all right? So it's better to connect automatically. That's recommended. You connect Tor and you wait for it to connect. So as you can see, it connected successfully, all right? So let's go to Start Tor browser. As you can see, the aim of the whole thing is the Tor browser and how anonymous you can be in the Tor browser. This keep you more anonymous, okay? So, but it's the same thing, but it's just the difference is using Tor on just a VPN, it's safe, but using Tor on Tails, it's safer. I hope you understand. So for speed, I'll use a Tor on Tails. Let's dive into the dark web. So like you all know, we have the surface web, which is the places where Google index websites. We have the deep web, which is like private content, not indexed. For example, email box and cloud files. Then we have the dark web, which is the hidden services accessible via onion domains are using Tor. So we're in Tor browser now, so we'll try to go through Tor and what you can, the ethical things you can use it for. Before we proceed, I would like to give you tips. Don't log into personal accounts here. You go to check.torproject.org. So if yours is connected, you're going to see this message. Congratulations, this browser is confirmed to use Tor. Your IP address, this is not actually your IP, this is just the Tor the IP is given to you. So when you go here, this here, this circuit, you see my toy is bouncing through the relays in Poland, Norway, and Germany. And don't download files unless you trust the source, but if possible, don't ever download the file here when accessing the dark web. So avoid enabling JavaScript. Some site may exploit it. So you never share personal information, okay? So there are myths and facts about the dark web. So people think only people who use dark web, people only use dark web for unethical purpose. That's not true, okay? Many people use it, for example, freedom of speech, censorship resistance, and privacy. All right, people also some people also feel these are myths for me, that Tor makes you 100% anonymous. Well, I wouldn't say 100% anonymous, but I would say it increases your anonymity, okay? But user behavior matters, because for example, there are things you just need to follow just to make you anonymous. When your Tor browser opens, just leave it at that default size it opens in the browser. Don't try to minimize it or maximize it, because when you do that, the size of the screen of your computer can be determined. So Tor normally use a DuckDuckGo. So this is the search here, the DuckDuckGo search. All right, to get to anything, to search for things you want on the dark web. So here, there are many people who use, like for example, the Proton Mail. So let's say I want to search for Proton Mail, their dark web link or their Onion site. So I can just say Proton Mail. Proton Mail dot Onion. So hit enter. So there are many big companies that have this thing. So you are being redirected to non-Java site, I think. So you remember we offed this thing for security. So here, as you can see, this is Proton, okay? And this is Proton Mail. You can access them through the dark web, okay? We even BBC have their own Onion this thing. Let's try BBC. Right. Okay, let's say BBC News Onion. So you just turn on your Onion router. So it brings to you informations related to only Onion sites. This is how you search for something online. All right, you can search for anything through this method. Then outside the DuckDuckGo, we have some browsers also, like the Nodeville browser, where you can also search. It's a good browser, the Nodeville this thing search engine, just like you have the Google search engine. So I always like to right click and open anything I'm trying to open in the dark web, because sometimes the link where it's taking you to might be different. So that's just for safety purpose.
Whatever you want to search.
So whatever you want to search, you can search, but I'll just end the video here. This video is just for educational purpose. I wouldn't go far because YouTube have community guidelines that I wouldn't cross.